All right, let's get started. This is the latch bar cardio and abdominal workout. We're going to do five sets, 3 steps each. We're going to do 60 seconds, jogging in place, 25 sit-ups, and 25 crunches. Let's check our timer. We got our clipboard. We have our floor mat. Let's get started. 60 seconds. That's all it is. But if you can't do 60 seconds, do what you can do. But do something. Remember, this is all about burning calories and exercising. Can't burn calories if you don't do some cardiovascular exercise. Whether you're riding a bicycle, using a treadmill, or using an elliptical, Stairmaster, jumping rope, whatever it is that you're doing, you need to include that in your daily routine. So if you're lifting weights, if you're using resistance bands, whatever it is you're doing, you still need to do cardio. 60 seconds at a time. That's all it takes. Now, we probably did a little more than 60 seconds, but it's okay. It's okay to do more. You don't want to do less. So set your goal and try and stick to your goal. Be disciplined, be consistent, and be determined. That way you will achieve your goal. Don't accept anything less. So you're going to have to work at whatever your goal is. You might as well get started. Diet is first. After your diet, then you include your exercise. If you think you can lose weight by exercising without dieting, it's not possible. So, let's do both so that you can strengthen yourself while you lose weight at the same time. Let's tone that body up and make it strong like it was years ago, because you're not as strong as you were years ago if you haven't been working out. So let's get started. Or you think you are because you've gained all of that weight. That's deceptive. So don't think that you are. You're not in shape. So let's get in shape and let's work on that blood pressure and let's work on that cholesterol, that A1C, all of that bad feeling that you get every day that you eat, the bloating, the gas, the arthritis. You can even work on your arthritis while you're working out. It improves everything, your digestive system. That's what working out is all about, and that's what you'll achieve. You'll feel better, you'll look better, you'll be better. Let's go with those 25 sit-ups. Follow it up with 25 crunches. Okay. As we age, we change. So we have to roll with the punch. Things that we did when we were much younger, we can no longer do. Not to that degree. You can still do it. You just probably can't do it as well. It depends on what you're trying to do. So, if you want to condition yourself or make your health better, you're going to have to work at it. So now, we're starting back from the beginning with step number two, or set number two, 60 seconds, jogging in place. So let's get those legs moving. Let's get that body moving. Let's get in shape. The only way to do it is to work out. So as your body changes with age, you have to change your mindset of what you should be doing and how you should be contributing to your better health. And you can contribute to your better health if you just apply some common sense, because your body is already talking to you. We're looking at those pounds that you put on, and it's letting you know, hey, you better do something about this. You better get it under control, because if you don't, you're going to be out of control. You're going to be on your path to contributing to bad health. And that's what you're going to get. Bad health. So you're going to have to work on it. 60 seconds, jogging in place. Let's follow it up. 25 sit-ups. Oh yeah. It's nothing to it. Once you get started, you will love it. You won't be able to stop, because you're going to get some rewards that you weren't getting when you were binging and eating everything you could possibly eat, because that's what we do. That's what we all do. How do I know? Because I'm one of those too. I'm just like you. Your brain is telling you that you want to eat more, because that's what your brain does. So now that you've stretched your stomach because of your speedy metabolism, now you want to slow things down. But your brain's not going to let you slow things down without a fight. That's all it is to that. So we better keep that in mind. Your brain is going to be telling you all the time, you need to satisfy that stomach, even though you're trying to eat less. That's what your brain does to you, because you've stretched your stomach, and now your brain wants you to fill it up all the time. So that's why you have to drink more water, because it'll help fill that gap that you don't fill with food, because you want to get your stomach to adjust to what you really should be eating, not what you were eating, what you really should be eating, what's nourishable. All that different craving that we do, all that temptation that happens to us, it's all controlled by our brain. Yes. And if you can't get that under control, you don't have a chance. So somehow you have to try and get that under control. And you can do it if you focus. Focus on what you're doing to yourself so that you can correct it. Remember, as we age, our body continues to change. We have to make the adjustment for our own survival, for our longevity. I know of all the challenges that are out there. We're all faced with the same challenges. We can't continue to make those challenges excuses. That's not going to bring your blood pressure down. That's not going to stop you from getting heart disease. That's not going to stop you from getting type 2 diabetes. So what are you going to do about You need to do something. And if you're a drinker, got to get that under control too, because that's also adding pounds to you just as well, whether it's beer, alcohol, what have you. And besides that, as you age, you need to stop drinking, because it's contributing to your bad health just as well. See, you could handle all this stuff when you were much younger. We all could. I did my share. I probably did your share too. But I've learned, and you should learn the same way, not the hard way, because all you're doing is ruining your life more and more. And you think that's fun? You lost a family member due to some drinking and driving, or your best friend or a loved one as a result of someone drinking and driving, you'd reconsider your thoughts on that. Not easy to give any poor habit up, including eating. And I understand you don't think that that's a poor habit, but when you eat too much, it becomes a very bad habit. Let's do 25 sit-ups. Most of us have an eating disorder, but we don't recognize it because we have this burning desire to fulfill our urge to eat all the time. Now, it doesn't mean that you're eating a plate full all the time. Those snacks, they add up, and those snacks are almost detrimental. Those snacks you have to be careful of, and you need to eat as few of those snacks as you possibly can, or plain old stop eating them, because they are addictive. 25 crunches. Let's go. I got a good question for you. How long would you let your car go without giving it a tune-up? Well, your body needs a tune-up just as well. Because if you don't tune your body up, things are really going to start to ail. You know what I mean? It's only going to get worse, in other words. So you're going to get aches and pains that you never thought you had, or you never thought you could imagine getting. So as you get older, the old body just starts to fall apart. Some of this stuff you can do something about. Yeah, you really can. But you can't if you don't try. You got to be conscientious about what you can possibly be doing to yourself at all times. Before you know it, time goes by real fast. You continue to do these bad things to yourself, you're going to be wondering, how and why did I get this? And then you're going to blame it on, oh, I inherited this. That's a bunch of baloney. You followed in the same footsteps. That's why you inherited. You gave it to yourself. That's basically what we do to most of our diseases that we get. And we contribute to our cancer, depending on the type of cancer that you get. Because where do you think it comes from? Food and obesity. We have to pay attention. We have to listen to our bodies. It's talking to us. Don't take things for granted. They're not going to change. You have to work on getting them better. You don't take your health seriously, then you've lost the battle. You've already given up. You have to be more serious about your health and showing your body love. You don't love yourself, not easy to love anyone else. Show your body some love. Remember, that's all you got. You don't have anything else. Your name is on it, but it's going to stay here when you leave. Let's do 25 sit-ups. Remember, we want to contribute to our better health. We've contributed long enough to our bad health. And if we don't make some adjustments, you're going to suffer the consequences more so. And perhaps sooner than you thought you would. Let's do 25 crunches. There you go. We just completed set number 4, which means there's one more set to go. So we're going to start off with step number 1, 60 seconds, jogging in place. We're doing cardio here. For step number 1, let's take a look at the second hand so we know where it's at, so we know when we should stop. This is all you need to do, but you need to do it daily. You need to be consistent. You need to be aggressive. And then you need to follow up and make sure you're properly dieting. And it doesn't get any better than exercising in your own home, in your privacy. There's too much competition out there. You can go to the gym, but once you take a look at all those muscle-bound guys and those muscle-bound women or good-looking women, that becomes even more of a challenge. And especially as we age, we know we can't compete, and it's hard standing next to someone that's tearing up the machinery and you can hardly move it. That's why you should work out in the privacy of your home. You don't have to worry about anyone looking at you, talking to you, or doing anything that you don't like. That's right. You can get yourself in shape, and it doesn't take a lot of space. Where you pay rent, where you pay mortgage, I'm sure you can find the space to work out. Doesn't take a lot of equipment. In fact, this latch bar here, $35 with one set of straps. You can see this latch bar on Shopify and also on the Latch Bar website, which is www.lw500products.net. You can also view more than 900 demonstrations on YouTube. Put in the search. My channel is at the Latch Bar. Let's do 25 sit-ups. And let's finish it off with 25 crunches. You can do it. Let's do it. There you have it. Set number 5, complete. Mark it on the clipboard. That's set number 2. We did a set earlier, and that is set number 2, more than enough for the day. Then you need to make sure you maintain your diet. Don't throw your workout into the garbage. Effectively, that's what you will do if you overeat. Focus on what you should be doing to improve your health. Otherwise, it's just not going to happen. So let's do the right thing. Work on healthy, good practices, and you will achieve your goal. Thank you all very much. Have a great day.